8, which is called synthetic fibers and plastics. So in the previous class, we come across the various types of synthetic fibers, right? At first, we came to know what is synthetic fiber and how it is made up of, right? So synthetic fibers, they are made up of by polymers, and these synthetic fibers, they are of several types. So we discussed all the types of synthetic fibers in the previous class, right? Those are rayon, nylon, then acrylic. These are the several types of synthetic fibers. And one more thing we are going to discuss, which is related to that synthetic fiber, that is the disadvantage of that synthetic fiber. The next we are going to discuss about the characteristics of synthetic fibers. Before getting into this characteristics of synthetic fibers, at first I will tell you the disadvantage of the synthetic fiber. When we burn the natural fabrics which are made up of by natural fibers and the fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers, during this activity we can notice one thing. What does that mean here? When we burn the fabric which is made up of by natural fibers, will burn as usual, okay? But when we burn the fabrics which are made up of by a synthetic fibers, starts to get melt. This is one of the disadvantage of this synthetic fibers. Whenever the cloths wear by a human beings catches fire, means what happens? It will be a disaster, right? So this is one of the disadvantage of this synthetic fiber. I think you got clear, right? The next, in your textbook they have mentioned one more activity, that is 3.2. Okay, from this activity you came to know about one of the property of the synthetic fiber. Now I will tell you the overall characteristics of synthetic fibers. From that activity also you will came to know one thing which is related to synthetic fiber. I will mention that also while I am explaining the characteristics of synthetic fibers. The next, what are the characteristics of the synthetic fibers? Already we come across the various types of synthetic fibers, right? So these synthetic fibers, they are cheaper. They are cheaper than that of natural fibers, right? So because of this reason, they are widely used in the preparation of fabrics, curtains, carpets, etc. Right? So here, the synthetic fibers, as they are very cheaper in price when we compare with that of natural fibers, they are more affordable, right? So this is one of the characteristic feature of the synthetic fibers. Next, the synthetic fibers, they are more stronger than that of natural fibers. Here means when we compare the strength of the fibers in between the natural and one more synthetic, means here the synthetic fibers, they are more stronger than that of natural fibers. This is the second characteristics of this synthetic fiber. The next, they are more durable, means we can use the fabrics or anything, any articles which are made up of by synthetic fibers for a longer duration of time. That is what we call durable, right? So here the synthetic fibers, they are more durable than that of natural fibers. The next, the fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers, they are very easy to handle and also to wash. Okay, this is the fourth important characteristics of synthetic fibers. The fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers, they are very easy to handle and easy to wash. This is one. The next, last, here in your textbook they have mentioned one activity which is called 3.2. Activity 3.2. From this activity you will came to know that the fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers, they are easily dried. Okay, means in a lesser duration the fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers, they get dried up. But when the fabrics which are made up of by natural fibers, they will take a longer duration of time. So here this is one of the advantage of a synthetic fiber, right? So here synthetic fibers, the fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers, what happens? They will get dried up very easily in a shorter period of time. So this is one of the importance of the synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers, they are cheaper than that of natural fibers. As we know that the artificial silk called rayon, which is cheaper than that of actual silk, right? The actual silk material is most costliest material, right? So when if you want to buy a silk fabric, it is most costly. But here the rayon, which is similar to that of silk, will have a property similar to that of silk. So we can easily buy the fabrics which is similar to that of original silk fabrics, but in a lower price, right? So here synthetic fibers, they are cheaper than that of natural fibers. They are more durable than that of natural fibers. Then they are more stronger than that of natural fibers, and they are easy to handle and also wash. And the fabrics which are made up of by synthetic fibers will get dried up very easily in a shorter period of time. This is all about the synthetic fibers. Okay, so now we came to know the thing which is related to synthetic fibers. Now we came to know definition of synthetic fibers. Then what are the synthetic types of synthetic fibers? Then what are the disadvantage of the synthetic fiber? And one more last, that is the characteristics of synthetic fiber. Right? The next in this class we are going to discuss about the one more topic which will come under this chapter, that is plastic. Now we come across the synthetic fibers. Right? The next we are going to discuss about the plastic. Okay, then what is plastic? I think you already familiar with this, right? So here, a plastic is a quite common thing in our daily life. Why? Because we will make use of many articles in our day-to-day life. So in this way, we are already familiar with that of plastic. So polymer is a long chain of monomer units, right? This is what we call polymer. Likewise, the plastic is also made up of by a large number of monomer units. In the last class, we already discussed about the monomer and also the polymer, right? The monomer means the smallest unit which we are going to use to make a article, right? So here, polymer means what happens? The polymer is a long chain of repeated units of monomer, right? But here, when it comes to the plastic, what happens? Is it not same in all the plastic? Means the arrangement of monomer units in the polymer is not same in all the plastic articles. Instead, they are of three types. Okay. Instead, they are of three types. What are those? First one, that is linear arrangement. Here, the monomers, they are arranged linearly. Means they are arranged in a straight line manner. Right. So this is what we call linear arrangement of monomer units to form a long chain of polymer. The next, the second one, that is cross-linked. Here, the monomer units, they are linked in all the directions. Okay, so not only in the form of a linear arrangement, but here we can see the cross-link arrangement of the monomer units to form a polymer. Okay, the third one, that is branched. Here we can see the monomer units, they are arranged in the form of branches. Means it is not in the form of straight line, but it is not in the form of all the direction. Here it is instead of these two, here we can see the branches. From one, again we can see the two branches. From this is what we call branched arrangement of monomers in a polymer. Okay, a plastic is a polymer. Here the arrangement of monomers in this polymer of a plastic is different. The arrangement of monomer units in the polymer of a plastic is different. What are those different ways? That is linear arrangement, then cross-linked arrangement, and one more, branch. Okay, the next, now we come across the plastic as a polymer and the arrangement of monomers in the polymer of a plastic, right? The next, that is types of plastic. And with that, we have two different types. One, that is thermoplastic, and one more, thermosetting plastic. Here, thermoplastic means it is possible to change its shape by the expenditure of heat energy. That what we call thermoplastic. When we apply heat to that plastic article, what happens? Suddenly there will be a change in the shape of that plastic material or an article. So such a type of plastic, what we call a thermoplastic, means we can change them in their shape. By what means? By the expenditure of heat energy. Okay, here, may I give an example for this thermoplastic? Consider the water bottle. Pour very hot water into the plastic water bottle and observe the changes. What happens when we pour the very hot water or boiling water into the plastic container? What happens? Suddenly the shape of that bottle gets changed because of the influence of heat from the boiling water, right? So here, this is what we call thermoplastic. Not only a water bottle, but also any other plastic container, when we pour a very hot substances into that, what happens suddenly it will change its shape, means it will get melt, right? So here, so this reason what we call that is thermoplastic. The next example, that is bucket. When we pour very hot water into the bucket, what happens? Suddenly it will start to melt by the influence of heat from the boiling water. So and it gets changed in its shape, right? So that is also one of an example for article or a plastic material which is made up of by thermoplastic. The next thermosetting plastic. Now we came to know the thermoplastic and also examples for the thermoplastic, right? The next, what is thermosetting plastic? Here, the plastic which is not possible to change its shape once if it is formed. Okay, so that is what we call thermosetting plastic. Here, thermosetting means it is not possible to change the shape of the plastic once if it is formed. That is what we call thermosetting plastic. Even under the influence of heat energy, this type of a plastic is not possible to change their shape. Okay, that is what we call thermosetting plastic. Consider an example. I think you already familiar with the handles of a cooking utensils, right? For example, the handles of tawa, handle of tawa, the next handle of cooker, okay, the handles of any frying pans. So here what happens, continuously we are used to use these utensils to cook food in our daily life, right? So what happens? Observe the thing here. When we pour a very hot or a boiling water into the water bottle, what happens? Suddenly there will be a melting of the plastic material and it changes its shape, right? Changes their shape. So, but here when we continuously we are making use of these kind of utensils in our kitchen, right? But here for these utensils again and again we are going to supply, right? So either in the morning or in the afternoon or in the evening, continuously we are making use of these kind of utensils in our kitchen, right? So but here the handle of tawa is not at all going to change its shape. Why? Here also we are applying same heat energy, right? Yes, why? Because it is one of the another type of plastic. Means the handle of tawa is not made up of by thermoplastic. It is made up of by thermosetting plastic. Okay, means here it is not possible to change its shape by the influence of heat energy. That type of plastic what we call thermosetting plastic. Example, handle of tawa or handle of cooker, okay, bakelite and melamine. These two are an examples for the thermosetting plastic. Here, bakelite is used in the preparation of handles of cooking utensils, and the bakelite it is also used in the preparation or production of food containers. Then it is also used in the preparation of switches. Okay, examples for the articles which are made up of by bakelite. Then what is this melamine? Melamine is also one of the thermosetting plastic. It is used in the preparation of tiles and floors. It is highly resistant material. It is a versatile material. It is not at all going to change its shape, or it is not at all going to change its chemical or physical properties by the influence of heat and heat energy. Melamine is also used in the preparation of cups, saucers, etc. These are the various examples where we can see the thermosetting plastics in our kitchen. Okay, bakelite and melamine. These two are the best example for the thermosetting plastic. The next, now we came to know the types of plastic, right? The next, that is, plastics has a materials of choice. Why only plastic? In our day, as I said in the beginning of this class, in our daily life, we are making use of many kind of plastic articles for our day-to-day life activities, right? So, here, why only we choose plastic articles? Here, why we are making use of only the plastic materials in our daily life? Why? Because plastic is cheaper than that of metals. Why? Because the containers which are made up of by plastic is easy to buy. Okay, when it compared with that of metallic containers. Okay, for example, water bottle. If you want to buy the metal water bottle, it will cost high, right? So because of this reason, usually we pick to buy the plastic water bottles. It will be easily available for 80 or 100 rupees, right? So this is one of the reason. Plastic is very cheaper than that of metal containers. Then next, plastic is easy to handle. Okay, means it is light in weight. Plastic containers or articles, they are very light in weight. So because of this reason also we are going to make use of plastic containers or any articles. If you want to place a metallic chair from or wood chair from one place to another place, it quite difficult it is, right? So if you want to if you want to make it easy, means usually we pick a plastic chair, right? So easily we can transfer a chair, plastic chair, from one place to the another place. Why? Because it is a light in weight when we compare with that of wooden chair. The next, plastic is will have a very good strength. Okay, whatever the thing or an article which is made up of by plastic, definitely it will have a good strength. Means it is a durable one. We can make use of these plastic articles for a longer duration of time. Then next, plastics, they are of moldable. Means we can see, just you have a look at your home, okay, you can see many things they are made up of by plastics, right? Why only we can see the many things which are made up of by plastic? Why? Because plastic is moldable one, can be shaped in any form. Moldable means here plastic can be shaped in any form. This is what we call moldable. So because of this moldable nature of plastic, it is possible to see the many articles which we are going to use in our daily life will be made up of by plastic. Okay, for example, chair, then food containers, then water bottles, then everything, etc. Right? So in this way, we are going to make use of many articles in our daily life which are made up of by plastic. Why? Because they are easily moldable, means can be shaped into the any form. Right? So the next, it is non-reactive. Plastic is a non-reactive. Why? What does this non-reactive mean, sir? When we compare with that of metals, what happens here? Consider any iron material, iron article, which is made up of by iron. Okay. So whenever it is exposed to the atmosphere, what happens? It gets corrode. But in place of this metallic article like iron material, so we are making use of plastic. Here it is possible to get corrode? No. Here plastic is not at all going to react with any atmospheric factor like water or air. Okay, so here it is a non-reactive one. Plastic is a non-reactive one. They are very poor conductors of heat and electricity. The plastic will not allow the current to pass through it. Okay, this is because these are all the various reasons. Because of these reasons, we are making use of plastic in our daily life. That is the properties of plastics. It is a non-reactive one. Just now I told you, the iron, if we consider any container or any article which is made up of by a metal called iron, okay, when it is exposed to the moisture content, what happens? It gets rusted, right? But in place of when it comes to the plastic, it is not at all going to react with any factors of atmosphere. Okay, so in this way it is a non-reactive one. The next, it is light and strong and it is durable. So I gave an example of a chair, right? So now I am giving one more example, that is water bottle. Okay, here a choice between a water bottle which is made up of a plastic and a metallic water bottle. Here what happens, the water bottle which is made up of by metal will weigh more when it compared with that of plastic water bottle, right? So in this way they are very light in weight. So not only a water bottle, any other articles which are made up of by plastic, they will have very light weight. The next, they are also strong in nature and they are also durable. Means like a metallic articles, these plastic articles, they will also have a very good strength and they are very strong in nature. The next, okay, what do you mean by durable? Means these articles will have a very long life. Means they will long, it is possible to make use of these plastic articles for a longer duration of time. So this is what we call durable. They are two conductors of an electricity. Consider a cutting plier or screwdrivers or the handles of cooking utensils. Okay, here what happens? Here also they will make use of plastic to make these articles, right? Electrical wires. Only the copper metal will allow the electricity to pass through it. But wire is not at all going to allow the current to pass through it, right? So here plastic is one of the non-conductive one. Means they are very poor conductors of heat and electricity. Consider the written the handles of cooking utensils in a kitchen. Okay, for example, handles of cooker, then handles of frying pan. Okay, these are all, these handles are also, they are made up of by plastic, but they do not allow any heat and electricity to pass through it. So in this way, the plastic is a poor conductors of heat and electricity. The next step, in this way they are very poor conductors of heat and electricity. The next step, plastic and environment. I think you are already familiar with this concept, right? Why? Because the plastic is one of the major reason for the pollution in our nature, right? So why? Because we are making use of many articles which are made up of plastic, and also as a result of this, we are throwing many articles which are made up of, means we are throwing plastic into the surrounding nature. Thereby what happens, this plastic will make a greater pollution in our surrounding nature, means in our environment. Let us discuss in what way it affects. The next, plastic and environment. Here, in this concept, we are going to discuss about the biodegradable substance and non-biodegradable substances. Biodegradable substance. Biodegradable substance means the substances which get naturally decomposed by the natural process. The biodegradable substance which decomposed by the natural process. That is what we call biodegradable substance. The next examples, waste. Peels of vegetables, fruits and other plant parts, they are easily get decomposed by the natural process. So these are the examples for biodegradable substances. The next, that is non-biodegradable substance. Here the substance is not at all going to decompose by the natural process. Here what is this natural process? That is decomposition, right? I think you already familiar with this. That is, here the substances which not at all going to decompose by any natural process. Here the decomposition mainly done by what? Microorganisms, right? Like bacteria, fungi. So these are the organisms, they are very active at the decomposition. So because of this reason, we call them as a decomposers. The decomposition will done by decomposers, and it is a very natural process. Okay. So here the substances which not at all going to decompose, those are known as non-biodegradable substances. Best example, that is plastic. Okay. So here plastic takes many years to decompose, for more than 500-600 years. It takes a longer duration of time to get decomposed. But the peels of vegetables or fruits, any other plant parts or dead animals, they get easily decomposed by the natural process. So this is what we call biodegradable substances and non-biodegradable substances. Here
you can see the types of waste, that is biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste, and the time taken to convert into the useful form or degeneration. Under that first one, that is the peels of vegetable and fruits and leftover foodstuff, etc. It will take 1 to 2 weeks to get converted into the useful form. Then second one, that is paper, it will take 10 to 30 days. The next, cotton cloth, it will take 2 to 5 months to get degenerate. Then wood, it will take 10 to 50 years to get degenerate. Then woolen cloths, it will take about a year to get degenerate. So up to here, what we discussed, all they come under a biodegradable waste. Within a particular time period, they will convert into the useful form. The next, the aluminium and other metal cans, it will take 100 to 500 years. So it is one of the non-biodegradable substance. Why? Because it will take a long period of time to get converted into the useful form. The next one, that is plastic bag. Same, in the same way, the plastic bag also will take several years to get converted into the useful form. So this metallic tins and plastic bags, they are the non-biodegradable substances. In this way, we can see the various types of waste.
So now we came to know the plastic is one of the non-biodegradable substances, right? So because of this reason, the plastic is not an eco-friendly component, right? So we need to avoid the use of plastic. Why? Because many things, the food, nowadays what happens, the food will also get wrapped by the plastic, right? So after having food, what happens, what we are going to do, that is again we are throwing plastic into the surrounding nature, that is into the environment. What happens, not only has every the every human being doing this. Okay, because of this reason, what happens? The plastic get accumulated in our surrounding and it is going to cause a pollution. Okay, at first it pollute the soil, later it pollute the water also. The next it pollutes the overall environment. Okay, in this way, what happens? The plastic has a very bad effect to the environment. So we should avoid the use of plastic. So the next, in what way we can avoid? By simply, whenever we are going to buy anything from the market, usually then we will get that by the plastic cover, right? Instead of this, make use of the bags which are made up of by cotton or any jute bag. So if we carry the cotton bag or jute bag to the market, what happens? Thereby, in this way, we can avoid the plastic bags. In this way, what happens? There will be no use of plastic bags, right? So this is also one of the method if you need to implement in our life, okay, to avoid the excess use of plastic in our life. The next is better to recycle the plastic. Why? Because most of the plastic materials, they are recycling one. Plastics, they are moldable, right? We can change the shape. So we can make use of this recycling process for the conversion of the used plastics into the again reusable ones. Last one more thing, that is 5R principle. Means we need to implement, as a citizen, we need to implement this 5R principle. The 5R principle means 5R: reduce, reuse, recycle, then recover, and refuse. So these are the things we need to implement in our daily life. We need to, in order to avoid the excess use of plastic in our daily life, thereby we can control the pollution rate also. This is all about the environment and plastic. This completes the chapter. Let's see in the next chapter. Thank you.